Hello and welcome to Wardens of the Cross. This is the Chaste Dating Guide, and today we are answering the question of why it is important to dress modestly when courting or dating. Firstly, however, I would like to introduce you to one of our sponsors, the Maidens for Mary. If you are a pure, chaste, and virtuous Catholic woman searching for like-minded ladies, then the Maidens for Mary is perfect for you. Go to www.maidensformary.blogspot.com to get into the action and meet women just like you. Again, go to www.maidensformary.blogspot.com today to be inspired towards living in the way of the Lord through your actions. Also, contribute today by hitting the like button and subscribing so that you can be notified to the release of each new video. What are your opinions on modesty? Let us know in a comment below and share us with your friends. Now, on to our episode. Anyone who has gone on a date or gone courting knows the dilemma over choosing what to wear. You want to wear something comfortable, something which your date finds attractive, and something appropriate for the occasion. Another thing must be considered, however, is the clothing modest? The importance of this question may be obvious to some, but to many others, women especially, the value of modesty is as worthless as plastic pennies. In the course of this episode, we shall discuss three reasons why anyone should dress virtuously. The objective we wish to attain in this endeavor is that you may be more aware of how sacred your body is, and why it is so important to hide it from prying eyes. The first reason we shall provide for dressing modestly is this. It shows the man whom you are trying to court that you respect yourself. One of the most important tasks at hand when trying to establish a long-term relationship is to show the male that you regard yourself as worthy of dignity and respect. If a girl goes out dressed in nothing but booty shorts and a midriff, it will indicate to any man seeking a good wife that the lady does not think much of herself. After all, if she did, why would she assume that she needed to reveal 90% of her body to gain any attention? A lady who believes she is worthy of respect and devotion, that she is sacred, must dress to match her ideology. Immodest dressing will either intimidate males from pursuing a serious relationship, or it will attract them for all of the wrong reasons. This leads us right into our second point. Our second point is that how one dresses will also determine what type of man is attracted to them and for what reasons. If a woman cares about how she is dressed and takes the time to cover herself well, this will deter anyone seeking physical relations alone. There is an extraordinary amount of abusive or sex-seeking men wandering the world, and nothing attracts these animals of society more than a female dressed in slutty fashion. If a lady is seeking a gentleman and one who respects the personal space of women, they must dress as a gentlewoman and not as a seductive harpy. Simply taking the time to wear a dress rather than midriffs and leg revealers will instantly weed out a majority of the dregs of society and deter them from seeking a courtship. Some men truly are dangerously addicted to the pleasures of sex and will seek any means to get it, including by preying on young women. Dressing well and in a non-revealing fashion will dissuade these predators from seeking you in particular. This is due to the fact that you hold yourself to a higher standard and will not serve to arouse their evil thoughts due to your modest and virtuous apparel. Holding yourself to a higher standard than the socially accepted norm is important, and this is how it makes its way to our third and final spot. As was just stated, our third and final point is that dressing immodestly is to be standard, dull, and unoriginal. To dress modestly is to put yourself at a higher level than the other women in the world. It is to indicate to any true gentleman that you are a woman to be taken seriously and a lady to be respected. anyone can buy themselves undergarments and call it clothing, but only those who respect themselves and hold themselves as sacred take the time to attire themselves as such. All women desire to be a queen or a princess, and, to be such, they must dress as royalty and conceal themselves. Dressing modestly draws attention and attracts the admiration of those who delight in virtue. To attract the right man, you have to put in the time and effort to do so. The world of today is full of women who seek to express their womanhood through simply discarding all veils and displaying it to the world. This is why romance in the modern era has been reduced to short sprees of physical passion or one-night stands. To dress decently and modestly is to immediately put yourself ahead in the search for a good husband. Next time you are preparing to go on a date or go and court your man, be sure you are dressed as you want him to see you. Do you want him to see you for the beautiful spiritual creation God made you to be? Do you want him to be proud to call you his sweetheart and someday call you his bride? Do you want him to love you faithfully with all his heart, soul, and self until the end of time? If so, take the extra moment to wear something which conceals your body. It preserves both you and your man completely, so that when you are wed, you may give yourselves in full to one another. God intends that all keep their bodies hidden so that they may have something special and sacred to offer to their spouse. A person's body is like a chest of the finest gold. One would not leave a chest of gems and riches sitting in public where any might take it, but they hide it and reveal it to only those who they trust the most. God gave each human the wealth of their virginity and physical features, and these are made to be shared and revealed only with one spouse. To conceal the body is to reveal the soul, and in the courting period, this is the true way to determine who shall be your eternal companion and who you can actually trust with your special and unique God-given riches.